A rigorous definition of the derivative requires a precise definition of a limit. But in a class for calculus for engineers, we're not particularly interested in rigor. We still need to understand what a limit is. So we write a limit of a function as the limit as x goes to a of f of x. And the meaning of this is, what is the value that f approaches as x approaches a? X doesn't have to be exactly at a, because f of a may be defined, but on the other hand, it may not be defined. And often in calculus, it will turn out to be 0 divided by 0. So we can look at an example of a limit that we'll see in calculus. So what is the limit as h approaches 0 of x plus h squared minus x squared divided by h? So if we just try to substitute in h equals 0, we would get x squared minus x squared, which is 0, divided by h, which is 0. So we get 0 over 0, which is an indeterminate limit. Indeterminate fraction. So in order to determine what this limit is, we need to get rid of 0 over 0. And to do that, we can do an expansion of this quadratic. So the limit as h goes to 0, this becomes x squared plus 2xh plus h squared minus x squared over h. The x squared cancels and the h factors. So that becomes the limit as h goes to 0. H times 2x plus h divided by h. We still have a 0 over 0, but now we see that h can be canceled. So that becomes the limit as h goes to 0 of 2x plus h. And at this point, we can substitute in h equals 0 and obtain the limit to x. So the limit as h goes to 0 of this function of h, x plus h squared minus x squared over h, is equal to 2x. If, for example, the limit as x goes to a of f of x is equal to f of a, so we can just substitute in x equals a, then we say f is continuous at x equals a. So that's the definition of continuity at a point. We can also have a function which is continuous over an interval. So if f is continuous on an interval, or it should be a closed interval, meaning that the endpoints are contained in the interval, then we view that as f has no holes, right? Not missing any points, no jumps, not jumping from one value to another value without passing through intermediate values, and no infinite divergences, no diversions. Okay? So another way of thinking about that is that f is continuous on an interval if you can draw the function f without lifting your pen from the paper. Okay, there's a very fundamental theorem in calculus, which is called the intermediate value theorem. Let me write that down. Intermediate value theorem. It's one of the most important theorems in mathematics, and it's introduced in calculus. So if we draw a graph of y versus x, the usual axis, and we have a function, okay? The endpoints are contained. This is the point A. This is the point B. If the function has the value f of A at the point A and has the value f of B at the point B, the intermediate value theorem says that the function, if the function f is continuous on the interval AB, then it will pass through every single value of y between f of A and f of B. It's kind of an obvious theorem, right? If you look at it, every value gets passed through. But the reason this theorem is so important to mathematicians is because in order to prove this theorem, you have to have a rigorous definition of the real numbers. We're not going to do that here because, as I've said before, engineers don't really need the real numbers. Engineers will do fine with just a finite subset of the rational numbers. But for mathematicians, this is an extremely important theorem, the intermediate value theorem. So let me review. In this video, I'm talking about the definition of a limit. The limit as x goes to a of f of x means the value that f approaches as x gets as close as you want to a. Sometimes when we just substitute in x equals a, we'll end up with an indeterminate expression like 0 divided by 0 or infinity divided by infinity. But nevertheless, you can work out some algebra, or later we'll learn to use calculus to compute a limit like this. I also introduced the concept of continuity. F is continuous at the point A. If this limit is equal to f of A, it's continuous on a closed interval. If there's no holes in the function doesn't jump values, and the function doesn't diverge to infinity. Finally, we talked about this theorem, the intermediate value theorem, which is a very dear theorem to mathematicians, but is kind of, we'll just use it on an intuitive basis. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.